demands of the trade union movement of officers in the banking industry would bless us with a strong deliberations to all of us, which would enrich one and all of us. I request our leadership to felicitate Comrade P.K. Sarkar on the dais. I would now request our leadership to felicitate Comrade Harvinder Singh. As we are already running behind the schedule, nevertheless, I would request Comrade P.K. Sarkar to give us the blessings in a brief manner. Comrade P.K. Sarkar, please.
Comrade Sunil Kumar, President of AIMBA, Comrade Mani Maran, the General Secretary of AIMBA, Comrade Sanjay Das, who is organizing this conference, my friend Comrade Harvinder Singh and Comrade Manjarekar, and all the responsible members of AIMBA. I could not attend the inaugural function
because today I have to receive the Shastra Sathi card, so I have gone there, so I came little late. Friends, these organizations, AINBF, All India Nationalist Bank Officers Federation, it has a great history. Perhaps the new generation of officers who have joined 5 years, 4 years back, or even 6, 7 years back, they perhaps don't know the background of this formation of this organization. It is on my heart because I vividly remember in early 2006-07, there was a burning issues before the entire banking industry about the second option on pension. And every time this demand is there, but ultimately it is not settled either by the IBA or the government. And there was a triennial conference in Chandigarh, and that time Comrade Amar Pal, he was the General Secretary of the AIBOC. And in that conference, in the open session, the General Secretary of AIBOC have told that second option on pension is not our issue. It is not a state bank issue. So, nationalized bank, they should think how they will settle this issue. And we, few of the units at that point of time, we are very furious. And on that night, I took the initiative and I request all the General Secretary of the Nationalized Bank to assemble. And in that meeting, we have decided that we will also form a Nationalized Bank Federation comprising of the all the Nationalized Bank. There was a lot of heart burning. It was very difficult. Initially, only few banks has come, and later on, almost all the banks had joined except few banks, 2-3 banks. And that organization was going very nice. And perhaps you can remember that day that for the first time in the history of the AIBOC, when the pension issue was settled, the initial move, the AIBOC General Secretary has not signed. It is the first time in the history. Comrade G.D. Nadav, he was the General Secretary, and he has reluctant to sign that first move about the cost of the second option on pension. And Comrade K.S. Shetty, who was the General Secretary at that time, founder General Secretary, he has signed as the AIBOC President. And when the final settlement takes place at that time, entire team, including State Bank of India comrade G.D. Nadav, has signed the agreement, and we got the second option on pension. And after that, after his retirement, comrade Harbinder Singh from Bank of India, he took over as a general secretary, and as a founder president of AINBF, I also worked with Harbinder Singh at that point of time. And that organization was going very nice. Again, some conspiracy has been done. Otherwise, today perhaps Comrade Manimaran could have been the General Secretary of the AIBOC from Canara Bank. But it has not happened. Due to some of affiliates, they have ditched AINBF and they were not part of the AINBF. I hope after merger, few banks already merged, and definitely in our forthcoming days, some of the banks will join. Union Bank, from which I belong, I had a talk with the new General Secretary, Comrade Bala from Bangalore. He told you, give me some time. Again, Union Bank will join with this organization. Once Union Bank will join, definitely the membership will cross around 1,50,000. There was a tendency that AINBF should be weak. If AINBF is weak, then State Bank of India can dominate. We are not against the State Bank of India. We all are the bank officers. But sectoral federation is there. Even regional rural bank, it is a sectoral federation of AIBOC. All India Nationalized Bank is a sectoral federation of AIBOC. But unfortunately, it was not happening. A day will come, you know the policy of the government. Perhaps in future days to come, only State Bank and the few nationalized bank will remain. And that point of time, it will be very much necessary a strong All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. And I hope a days will come, definitely these organizations will be in the forefront for the betterment of the officers' community. It is on my heart that these AINBFs should prosper us, these AINBFs should get stronger and stronger, because many leaders, they have built this organization. Initially, we don't have a fund of AINBF, but I have gone through the report. I have not seen the accounts. But I know that by this time, perhaps, it has crossed crores of rupees. So financially, it will be a very strong one, and definitely a new leadership. Again, it will come to the AINBF. They will strengthen this organization. On behalf of my personal and on behalf of the entire officers community, I am very much thankful to the organizer to call me here, and I got the opportunity to get the to speak a few words before you. Thank you very much, friends. Thank you. We'll see again. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Comrade Sarkar. I would now request the former General Secretary of AIVOC, Comrade Harvinder Singh, to give his blessings.
मेरे छोटे भाई, All India Bank Officers Confederation के अध्यक्ष, All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation के अध्यक्ष और Federation of Bank of India Officers Association के महामंत्री, एक जुझारू नेता जिनको अपनी योग्यता साबित करने के लिए कुछ नहीं कहना पड़ता, उनके शब्द बोलते हैं, उनका आचरण बोलता है, उनके कथन बोलते हैं, भाई कॉमरेड सुनील कुमार, ऑल इंडिया नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक ऑफिसर्स फेडरेशन के महासचिव, एक और जुझारू नेता जिन्होंने ऑल इंडिया बैंक ऑफिसर्स कन्फेडरेशन के अंदर मेरे कंधे से कंधा मिलाकर कार्य किया, कॉमरेड मणिमारन जी, former leader of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation in many capacities and founder member of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation, Comrade P.K. Sarkar, to whom you listened just now, working president of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation and general secretary of former SBOA, Comrade Sanjay Manjrekar, and another younger brother of mine who has always felt proud in following my footsteps, Comrade Sanjay Das, other leaders, senior leaders sitting on the other side, and my dear friends, brothers, sisters, comrades. First of all, I convey my sincere thanks to the leadership of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation for giving me a chance to address you for only 5 minutes, because that is the time allotted to me, and I sincerely know that in the business session, if they are allotting me time, that is only a favor to me, and I assure you that I will not take more than 5 minutes. Friends, I will not repeat whatever has been told. In the morning, Comrade Manimaran told the objectives in detail about formation of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation, and now Comrade P.K. Sarkar has told you the immediate necessity of forming All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation when the issue of second option of pension came and was discussed in All India Bank Officers Confederation's National Executive Committee, and the remarks made by our senior brothers, so-called senior brothers, about the pension option, कि हम साधु नहीं हैं कि और किसी के लिए लड़ेंगे. On that day only, the leadership of All India Nationalized Banks decided that we'll form our organization, which will go for the interests of nationalized banks, staff and officers, and right to the very purpose of foundation of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation, the achievements of second option of pension, and then one more achievement which perhaps nobody has mentioned here since morning, that was another option of pension for VRS employees. That was the sole effort of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. Their AIBOC did not help, and in many parts, even the leadership of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation also could not know when it got achieved. Though beneficiaries were very few, but that is also an achievement, friends. Comrades, it's unfortunate that even those federations or constituents who took lead in formation of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation are missing today. I can simply pray to the God that good sense will prevail upon them, and they will very soon join back the All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. Because not only their issues remain unresolved, but the capacity, capability and efficiency of the leaders from nationalized banks have proved their worth at AIBOC. Recently, a wage revision MOU which has been signed for officers at the industry goes to prove the leader from Nationalized Bank own Officers Federation only can do that. Comrade Sunil Kumar deserves the best of compliments, as has been acknowledged by State Bank of India Officers Federation General Secretary also, that many things which Comrade Somia did not know were being managed by Comrade Sunil Kumar from behind. And friends, you deserve a compliment under this scenario. When the COVID was at the height, this type of settlement has taken place and you are all being benefited out of that. Friends, I will request you, I will make an appeal to you. You make all out efforts, like Comrade Amarjit Kaur has also told. This is not the responsibility only of leadership of INBOV. This is the responsibility, this is the responsibility of each one of you who have come from all over the country to ensure that those constituents which have left, maybe temporarily, because of certain motives, because of certain purposes, because of politics, they are also brought back, and All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation once again emerge a very strong organization and achieve many more benefits for you. I once again convey my sincere thanks to the leadership, particularly Comrade Sunil Kumar and Mani Maranji. They have invited me, they have asked me to address you. With all good wishes to all of you, I salute the leadership of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. Long live our unity, long live. Long live our unity, comrades. Long live, long live. Thank you.
Long live our unity. Thank you, Comrade Harvinder Singh, for your blessings and inspirational speech. With this, officially we are coming to the closure of the open session, which extended post-lunch with the permission of the President and the presidium that is going to be formed. To form the presidium, already the central leaders are there of the NBOF. I would request Comrade Krishnan, the Secretariat, and Comrade Prabhu, the Treasurer, to kindly come on to the dais so that the presidium can be formed and the delegate session can be commenced. Comrades, the fifth triennial session of All India Nationalized Banks Officers Federation is going to commence. On the presidium, we have the President, the General Secretary, the Chairman of the Reception Committee and of the Host Unit, and the other office bearers. To start the delegate session, I now hand over the mic to the President of the Federation to commence the delegate session. Thank you.
Comrades on the dais and my dear delegates, I call this house to order, and now the business session shall be taken up. I refer to the notice dated 5th January 2021 issued by the General Secretary of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. And I propose to move agenda-wise. Agenda 1, to consider and adopt the General Secretary report. Agenda 2, to consider and adopt the audited statement of account for the year ended 2018-19-20. And on audited statement or account for the remaining period. Third, to consider amendment to bylaws as recommended by the Central Committee or the amendment by the members for which due notice have been given. And fourth, to consider the resolution, proposition, motions recommended by the Central Committee and or brought forward by the members after giving the due notice. Before I proceed, and I ask the General Secretary to place his record, let me tell you, my dear friends, that the report was circulated to you all well in advance. And I understand that you must have read it. Even if you have not read it, go back in the evening, read in the night, and whatever suggestion you want to give, that you can give to the AINBF office upon examining your amendment, that will be duly incorporated in the report, that will be the part of the report. So when I will ask the General Secretary to go through the report, he will go through only the statutory paragraph, that is introduction, homage, acknowledgement, and few others which he would like to. Apart from that, the second agenda about the statement has already been discussed and passed by the Central Committee, that is annexed to the General Secretary report. So placing it will be a formality. And even if you observe that some clarification is needed by you, if you are ready with those clarification, you will get the time, else you can submit your resolution through the mail to the office. Third, to consider amendment to the bylaws, the Central Committee has already authorized the Presidium to take a view, and that General Secretary will take up along with this report and accounts, and fourth, the resolutions. You must have heard Comrade Amarjeet Kaur that she was speaking about the resolution, and when you, if you might have gone it, then all the resolutions, 19 resolutions, are very appropriate, and we have to get it by heart. Not only get it by heart, we have to translate it into our action. So General Secretary will place his report. If at all you find, if there is some time, you can come, you can deliberate. Time will be a constraint. And one thing I will remind, we always believe in freedom of expression. I guarantee you the freedom of expression, but I do not guarantee you what will happen after your expression. So that you bear in mind. My authority will be up to giving you the freedom. So when the freedom is given, use it judiciously. Don't pass any unwanted comments. Don't go for the repetition. Put your point, and it is better that if you wish to use all those things, then send mail. No, that is not there. If they have something, because when you are going to take up the General Secretary report, the relevant portion, boss, when I was going for the meeting, 15%, when I will ask what is this 15%, people will generally answer 15 out of 100. That is the understanding. So we also know about our constituency, but even then, the reading is a good habit which you should adopt. If you have read, time is not a constant. So General Secretary, kindly place the report, and you take up all the four agendas together. Thereafter, we can invite the people. In the meantime, those who have already read the report, they can send their name so that I can invite them for their comments on the report. Thank you, friends.
Jindabad, Jindabad. Thank you very much, President Saab. He is reminding me the style of present government. You are having a permission to talk, but what to talk, I will tell you. a good freedom of speech. But still, I am giving an assurance to you. If he is, I will take care of the president's job. If you really want to talk, you talk. No issues. At the outset, I expected my learned president will appreciate at least the color and the style of the report. I expected.
No. I will tell you that
Thank you very much, sir. Let us get into the business of this meeting. Friends, today from Madam, our Sarkarda, our Arvindarji, you might have heard why the trade union in general from the Madam and why ANBF in particular from Sarkarda and our Arvindarji. In fact, with a great expectation and aspiration, this organization was started. In between, somebody for some reasons, without realizing what this organization can do for the public sector banks, they were not part of it. Perhaps, as our president was telling, what was supposed to be read, they might not have read. So they didn't understand what is the kind of damage they are causing to the nationalized bank officers movement. Though it is a repetition, I would like to reiterate again. When bank government has started these changes in the system, you just see that recall. Everything was targeting only public sector banks. When we oppose this MD should not be brought from private. Private bank ka kya hota hai? Nothing. When we want officers, representatives should be in the board of the bank. Private banks ka kya hota hai, sir? Woh bhi nationalized bank hai. When the government has insisted no capital infusion, what is going to happen to the private sector banks? Again, it is for the public sector banks only. Anything which this government has introduced in the form of reforms, which were very actively going on, though it was started in 91. It was targeting the exit of public sector banks only. So necessarily, only the nationalized banking sector, they will have to fight against the reforms primarily. Private sector bank ko, yaar, RRBs ko, cooperative sector ko, koi role nahi isme. So, in fact, we should have strengthened this organization further. But what it should have been, it is not. But let us not do the postmortem. At least today you had an opportunity to hear from the horse mouth. What is trade union? What is the need for the trade union? Why the trade union movement is very much required in nationalized bank officers movement, you hear. I am seeing a very promising faces here. Youth, and you are not demoralized. Rather, you come up with a bubbling enthusiasm in participating in the meeting. 1.5 hours, Madam's address, very patiently this crowd was hearing. Fine. It shows your commitment, involvement for the cause you come over here. So, I feel days to come, not only you, because you understood, others not joining in the wagon also will understand the importance of patronizing this All India Nationalized Officers Federation, and they will strengthen it, and we will be ensuring officers in the public sector banks, so that life will be reasonable. Thank you very much. Let me get into that. Dear President, Office Bearers, Delegates and Observers, on behalf of the Central Committee, I have great pleasure in welcoming all of you. My special thanks to the State Committee of West Bengal for accepting the request for hosting this conference, Kolkata, the birthplace of ANBF. I place on record my appreciation to the State Committee of West Bengal under the able leadership of Comrade Sanjay Da, State Secretary of ANBF, Office Bearers and the committee members for the West Bengal State Unit and dedicated volunteers for the excellent arrangement made by them and their hard toil in making this event a memorable for all of us. The 3 years since our last triennial has been a turbulent one for the Indian banking sector, especially the nationalized bank. The government has gone ahead with its agenda of privatization of the public sector banks with implementation of the first part in the garb of amalgamation. Number of nationalized banks has come down from 19 to 11 at present. Apart from State Bank of India, there are talks at the highest level to even reduce this number to 4 to 5 large-sized banks by amalgamating, privatizing the remaining small banks. There are talks unleashed on the nationalized banks have been unrelenting with a single agenda of stripping the nationalized banks of their nationalized status. So with this word, I welcome all of you friends. I will move to the homage. During this last 3 years, the nation and internationally too, we lost the important souls after their committed presence. We lost them. I offer my respectful reverence to our members who have lost their lives while serving the bank, our fellow countrymen who have unfortunately lost their lives to natural calamities like floods, cyclones, various accidents, mishaps in the country, those men in uniform, the brave soldiers who sacrificed their lives protecting our country, the policemen who lost their lives in their battle with the terrorists and insurgents while safeguarding the country and its citizens, prominent personalities who have departed this world in the past 3 years, and those who made a difference in the society by excelling in their chosen field, leaving an indelible mark of their existence even after death. It starts from our former president, son of the soil, Pranab Mukherjee, Comrade S.R. Sengupta, who has seated the All India Bank Officer Confederation today, which has grown up to this level. We are all the present just attracted by his style of running the trade union, and we the youth during those days, it is really, I am admitting that we are simply attracted by his style of doing that. We lost him. Arun Kumar Roy, veteran trade union leader. Another is Gurdas Das Gupta, from whom Madam has taken charge. The unsolvable problem for any trade union, we used to approach Mr. Guptaji only. He used to do that. He lost him. And Subhash Savant, another trade union leader who was the former Defence Minister George Fernandes, his role in railway strike, every one of us is aware of it. Pratik Prakash Banerjee, Judge, F.C. Kohli, and our former Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, T.N. Sheshan, former Chief Election Commissioner, Tarun Gogoi, Keshwai Patel, Ram Vilas Paswanji, Mulayam Singh Yadav, politician, he is a different politician for UP, don't get confused. Jaswant Singh, former Minister of Finance and Defence. The A singer, S.P. Balasubramaniam, Krishna Kumar, Vasanta Kumar, A.R. Lakshmanan, Chetan Chauhan, Saroj Gaon, and veteran actor who was our dream boy, Rishi Kapoor. All very notable personalities, my dear friends. We have lost a huge number of persons in the last 3 years. List goes in a big number. And besides these personalities, innumerable human lives have been lost on various tragedies, natural and man-made disasters, dastardly terrorist attacks all over the world, including almost 19 lakh lives lost in the COVID-19 pandemic also. We dip our banner in earnest remembrance of all those departed souls and pray the Almighty to shower their families with necessary courage to overcome the loss. May the departed souls rest in peace. Let us observe a minute silence as a mark of respect to these departed souls. With the permission of our president, I'll move to page number 42, which discusses about national economy, which as a banker you all must know about. Kindly go to page number 42, under item 5, national economy. In India, The data release of the National Statistics Office showed a contraction of 7.5% real GDP during July to September quarter. In the third quarter of 2020-21, indicators pointed to recovery, with double-digit growth in passenger vehicles and motorcycle sales, railway freight traffic and electricity consumption in October. Although there was a moderation in some of these indicators in November, which indicates that we are gaining momentum again. The outlook for agriculture remains bright, riding on the favorable monsoon and rabi sowing up by 4% from the acreage covered at this time last year. Monetary Policy Committee of RBI also continued with the accommodative stance of monetary policy to revive growth on a durable basis and mitigate the impact of COVID-19 while ensuring that inflation remains within the target going forward. The committee estimates that the recovery in rural demand is expected to strengthen further, while urban demand is also gaining momentum, unlocking sports activity and employment, especially of labour displaced by COVID-19. These positive impulses are, however, clubbed by a possible rise in infections in some parts of the country, prompting some local containment measures. Fitch Ratings projected India's GDP forecast to -9.4% in the FY 2021 from a previously projected contraction of 10.5% after the economy staged a sharper rebound in the second quarter. While releasing the global economic outlook, Fitch remarked that the coronavirus recession has inflicted severe economic scarring and the country needs to repair balance sheets and increase caution about long-term planning. The projections come out to GDP growth of 4.2% 2019-20 fiscal and 6.7% annual expansion between 2015 and 2019. The outlook appears to be brighter owing to an expected rollout of various vaccines in 2021. India has pre-ordered 1.6 billion doses, including 500 million doses of Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. World Bank has also projected in its global economic prospects report that growth in India, the pandemic hit the economy at a time when the growth was already decelerating. Output is projected to fall by 9.6% FY 2020-21, reflecting a sharp drop in household spending and private investment. The pandemic disproportionately affected activity in the service sector, mainly in urban areas such as retail, paralyzed consumption, and caused significant unemployment. Recent data indicate that the service sector recovery is gaining momentum, but the informal sector, which accounts for 4/5 of the employment, suffered severe income losses. India is expected to recover to 5.4% in 2021 as the rebound from low base is offset by muted private investment growth given financial sector weakness. The pandemic will likely lower potential growth, including through eroding human capital and investment growth. The report further states that non-performing loans were already at high levels in the financial sector before the pandemic, and the economic downturn may lead to a further insolvencies among financial and non-financial corporations. The ratio of gross non-performing loans to assets of commercial banks in India could be as high as 15% in March 2021. Friends, budget, you are all well aware of it because we are waiting for another budget. I invite you to come to page number 50. Page number 50. It is regarding banking, mergers and amalgamations. The union government constituted alternative mechanism panel to oversee merger proposals of public sector banks. This alternative mechanism was set up by the government to fast-track consolidation among the public sector bank. The mechanism was supposed to oversee the proposals coming from boards of PSBs for consolidation. It was told, but rather it was instructed all the boards, what kind of proposal they will pass. You all know that. Finance Ministry has announced mega mergers. Boards were directed to pass the resolutions. State Bank of India merger with its 5 associate banks, State Bank of Patiala, State Bank of Picardy in Jaipur, State Bank of Raipur, State Bank of Travancore, State Bank of Hyderabad, as well as with the Bharatiya Mahila Bank, came into effect from October 1, 2017. Bank of Baroda amalgamated with the Dana Bank and Vijaya Bank from 1st April 2019, this was India's first ever three-way consolidation banks in India. Subsequently, Government of India announced creation of 4 new banks by merging 10 public sector banks, Canara Bank with the Syndicate Bank, Union Bank of India with Andhra Bank, Corporation Bank, Punjab National Bank with Oriental Bank of Commerce, United Bank of India, and Indian Bank with Allahabad Bank. The above amalgamation came into effect from 1/4/2020. All the acquired banks, Allahabad Bank, Andhra Bank, Corporation Bank, Dena Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce, Syndicate Bank, United Bank of India, and Vijaya Bank had a unique geographical presence and identity. Similarly, they also had a unique culture. be it in their functioning or be it to servicing to a particular area of our country specifically. With the merger, such identity and culture are lost. In the name of amalgamation, general public are made to believe that it is not a particular bank which helps them in meeting out all their requirements. During the amalgamation exercise, it was announced that 6 banks were not amalgamated, among which 2 banks, Bank of India and Central Bank of India, were allowed to continue since they were being named as banks of national presence, and other 4 banks, Bank of Maharashtra, Indian Overseas Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, and Interred Commercial Bank, were allowed to continue because of their regional presence. Preserving these public sector banks are very much essential since they have been left out specifically because of their presence either across the country or specific to a region. Moreover, it is also essential that the existing private sector banks are also nationalized so that the resources remain with the government for proper deployment to private sector and also for easier regulations. Kindly go through that. What we are insisting as a point of ANBOB is the regional banks, they have got a special culture and their own style of servicing the people in a particular sector or particular region. So those banks must continue as a public sector bank. That we are telling that. Apart from that, it disturbed private sector banks rather to be converted into public sector bank. This is ANBOB stand. Further, at the time of amalgamation, it was promised by none less than Union Minister of Finance that the best HR practices prevailing among the amalgamated banks would be made available to all the staff members of the amalgamated entities. But this is not being followed in many amalgamated entities. Yes, even our amalgamation also one of the examples. Some of the best practices we were maintaining either in Syndicate Bank or in Canara Bank, all the best things were not introduced as promised by the Finance Minister. There are already talks at Finance Ministry level that only 4 to 5 public sector banks need to remain in the system and the rest may be amalgamated or privatized. The recent announcement by Finance Minister that there will be a maximum of 4 public sector bank in companies in strategic sectors and state-owned firms in the other segments will eventually be privatized as credence to the award. And regarding the prompt corrective action, they did, and it is only a preventive action to brand some banks as a loss-making so that it will be closed, privatized or amalgamated. And come to other developments, 9.3, a decision on residual ₹14,500 crores capital infusion of in the public sector banks is expected from Ministry of Finance in the fourth quarter of 2021. The government approved capital infusion of ₹5,500 crores through preferential allotment of equity shares in Punjab Sindh Bank recently out of the ₹20,000 crores allotted for capital infusion of PSBs as part of the first batch of supplementary demands for grants 2020-21. Indian Banks Association has formed a committee to look into the nuances of staff accountability and suggest a uniform practice on employee accountability for bad loans and other risk-oriented business calls to prevent potential vigilance in the guise of probing lapses. The panel will recommend steps that will be adopted by the lenders. The uniform policy is proposed to be adopted, taking the best practices for a different bank, while also taking into account the discipline and appeal regulations. And this committee is headed by Mr. M.V. Rao, ED of Canara Bank. I learned that in the first meeting itself, they decided to hear the trade union also. Accordingly, IBOC was called. And our Apex organization, they have placed beautiful arguments to ensure that your pragmatic decisions are guarded. Whatever decision taken by the officers in the process of credit dissemination should not be affected. All these things, good points have been given, and 2 days back it was circulated to you also. Let us hope for the best accountability policy so that the officers will be getting into the business building without any fear. And 8 of India's biggest banks saw a significant jump in willful defaults in the first half of FY21, with such loans rising by over ₹37,000 crores to 1.5 lakh crores as per data on suit filed accounts from Credit Bureau, TransUnion, CIBIL. These banks, State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Union Bank of India, ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank and Axis Bank, account for 75% of all loans reported as willful defaults for the event period. DBS Bank, Bank India Limited, had received a capital infusion of ₹2,500 crores from DBS Bank Limited, Singapore, to support its amalgamation with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. The scheme of amalgamation came into after the RBI placed a crisis at LVB and a moratorium and announced its merger with DBAL. Ministry of Finance had stated that banks have sanctioned loans worth of rupees 2.05 lakh crores to about 81 lakhs account under the rupees 3 lakh crore emergency credit line guarantee scheme for the small and medium enterprises sector. This was impacted by disruptions caused due to COVID-19 pandemic. Reserve Bank of India directed the country's largest private sector lender HDFC to temporarily halt all its digital launches as well as new sourcing of credit card customers following the various outages the bank faced due to technology glitches in the past 2 years. Indian Bank approved the appropriation of around rupees 18,976 crore accumulated losses from the share premium account of the bank. And Indian Bank carried the accumulated losses due to amalgamation with Allahabad Bank. Friends, you all must, with a deliberate intention only, it is all placed to you. Kindly go through that for the office bearers. It may be a good talking point for also whenever you are addressing the members. When they are appropriating these accumulated losses from the premium account, share premium account, it means to that extent the net owned funds got eroded. Net worth got eroded. Capital got eroded. So the amalgamation of Allahabad Bank with Indian Bank ultimately resulted in erosion of the capital to the tune of 18,976 crores. This is what you must understand. And the Department of Investment and Public Asset Management and the Finance Ministry floated a request for proposal to appoint a consultant for advice on stake sale in banks and insurance companies. The government had set a disinvestment target of 2.10 lakh crores for the current fiscal, out of which disinvestment of government stake in public sector banks and financial institutions, including LIC and IDBI Bank, is rupees 90,000 crores, while the remaining is to come from sale of stake in central public sector enterprises. In the finance sector alone, by selling the government holding, they are planning to gain rupees 90,000 crores. The Banking Regulation Act Bill 2020, which is an amendment to the Banking Regulations Act 1940, was passed in Parliament. The bill provides power to RBI to initiate scheme for reconstruction or amalgamation without imposing any moratorium. Again, understand. And RBI can also an exempt to the cooperative bank or class of cooperative banks from certain provisions of the Act through notification. Without moratorium also, the bank can be closed, privatized or amalgamated. RBI warned consumers against the questionable digital money lending entities that promises loans in seconds at exorbitant rates of interest and then use muscle powers to record use. RBI advised that individuals and small business should verify the antecedents of the company offering loans online or through mobile apps. RBI report on the trend and progress of banking in India said that commercial banks' gross non-performing asset ratio declined from 9.1% March 2019 to 7.5% September 2020. The COVID-19 provisioning and the plowing back of dividends helped in shielding their balance sheets. That's what the game. And we have changed the provisioning norms because of the COVID-19. And that is the reason that the NPA percentages come down. It is not the real recovery was affected during the COVID-19 situation. The Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank received expressions of interest from 4 suitors and the proposals are being examined for viability, feasibility and also to check whether these are the interest of the depositors. Meanwhile, the regulator has also extended the restrictions placed on PMC by 3 months till March 31st, 2021 until the proposals are studied. Reserve Bank of India introduced a positive pay system from January 2021 for check transactions above rupees 50,000. This is done to enhance the safety and eliminate frauds. The checks where the transactions above 50,000 involve reconfirmation of key details of checks by the issuing customer to his bank. Reserve Bank of India revised the private sector lending norms as per which loans up to rupees 50 crore for startups in agriculture and MSME sector would be given under private sector. This support the lending limit for health infrastructure has also been doubled to rupees 10 crores. A 5-member expert committee was constituted under Sri K.V. Kamath, former CEO of ICICI Bank, for adopting a resolution framework for COVID-19 related stress. The committee identified 26 stress sectors under the framework of, and Reserve Bank of India notified that it will cover these 26 stress sectors under the TLTRO scheme. Canara Bank Limited has launched a national common mobility debit card. It is the first ever contactless debit cum prepaid rupee card of the bank and is an interoperable transport card. This debit card has been launched in line with the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs vision. Reserve Bank imposed a moratorium on the capital starved Yes Bank, superseded the board head and appointed Sri Prashant Kumar, who was serving as the Chief Financial Officer and Deputy Managing Director of State Bank of India, as an administrator. Later, a draft scheme of reconstruction that entailed SBI investing capital to acquire 49% the restructured private lender with the 8 companies including SBI, ICICI Bank, Kotak Mahindra, HDFC and Axis Bank, among others, chipping it to save the troubled bank. These are all the investments from these banks into Yes Bank. Yes Bank is sinking. Now we are appointing a committee to study that. In the biggest fraud ever in India's banking industry, Punjab National Bank, the country's second biggest bank, reported that it had been defrauded of about 12,700 crores by two jewelry groups who raised credit from overseas bank based on fraudulent guarantees issued. The perpetrators of the fraud, Mr. Nirav Modi and Mehul Chokshi, have fled the country well before the information came into public domain. The passing of insolvency and the bankruptcy code is another step wherein by placing so many provisions, a lot of means are provided to corporate for paying lesser amount. Haircut. The jugglery of words used in this regard make people to think that word haircut is something different from the common word write-off. In the write-off, there is some restriction. Haircut means it could be totally bald also. Totally they can write-off. And public opinion is being deliberately manipulated to create an impression that IBC is a panacea, whereas in real terms the finance institutions are made to suffer huge losses from the provisions made by them. Recently, it is learned that the liabilities of Videocon are to be resolved with a haircut of almost 90%. 90% of the existing liability recoverable is, you understand what is it. Page number 60, you come to ANBF functioning. Item number 12. All India National Bank Officers Federation was formed with the objective of protecting the interests of the officers of National Bank. Considering the COVID-19 situation in the country and to strengthen the hands of the government in alleviating the plight of our fellow brethren across the country, ANBF donated a sum of Rs. 25 lakhs to the PM CARES Fund. ANBF took up with the Ministry of Finance, Reserve Bank of India and Indian Bank Association when nationwide lockdown was implemented for containing the spread of virus. The issues included safety of the bank, bank employees attending office during lockdown, preventive safeguards to be adopted, compensation for the employees dying of COVID infection, specially work from home or the pregnant women, specially abled and visually challenged, people are having chronic illness related to heart, liver, lungs, kidney, respiratory of the age, specially for those affected by coronavirus and underwent hospitalization, quarantine. Similarly, the state committees also took up with respect to SLBCs on the above lines for the benefit of our members. Friends, it might have given a hint to you. All the Nationalized Bank Officers Federation can separately take up directly with IBA and the government also any issues specially related to the public sector bank officers. And we have utilized that opportunity and we will continue to do so more effectively in the days to come. As I told that many of the problems faced by the officers in the bank industries pertaining to the public sector banks only. A fitting reply was sent to the chairman, Indian Banks Association, for publishing a misleading advertisement to print a wrong picture on the bank employees and officers in the eyes of general public. First time in the history of ANBF, a separate strike notice was issued for our genuine demands on wage revision and other issues. CLC had called us for reconciliation meeting on 27th March. Due to the implementation of the lockdown, the meeting was postponed. Again, I am trying to give us a hint to you. ANBF was an independent body registered under the Trade Union Act separately, though we are part of the ABOC. When issues which affects the ANBO, public sector bank officers, we are empowered to give the notices separately. And the Central Labour Commission also has recognized as a trade union and they called us for a discussion also separately. This right is with you. So how to use it, when to use it, for what we should use it, we must decide. So my request is hereafter we will be very active. We will have to give an agitation call separately to take care of the public sector bank. We must do that. And Comrade Sunil Kumarji, General Secretary of Federation of Bank of India Officers Association, President of ANBF, was co-opted as the President of our Apex Body, IBOC. ANBF fought for the cause of the bank officers, demanded wage revision, the principles of minimum wages, which is based on the need-based minimum wage determined for a single worker and adopted in 5th Indian Labour Conference, held on 1957, made applicable for the central government employees for the 7th Central Pay Commission, which forms the crux of the Code on Wages Act enacted during August 2019. Though our charter demands was based on the minimum wage principles, IBA never discussed on those lines and stuck to the earlier system adopted till then. Three writ petitions were filed in Madurai bench of High Court of Madras, while the first writ was filed by an officer, Mr. Dhanasekhar, praying for equal pay considering the government of India has equated JMG scaling officers to the grade A officers of the central government while revising the income ceiling for calculating the OBC creamy layer. Second, it was filed by Mr. Sandana Pandian seeking equivalence of pay for all OBC employees. The third, it was filed by Mrs. R. Saravanan, non-OBC officers seeking equivalence of pay for all officers and revision of pension for retirees on the lines of central government. After passing the Code on Wages Act, a retired senior manager, Mr. Alex, filed a writ petition in the High Court of Madras requesting for court to direct DFS to confer legal status to IBA before continuing the wage negotiation in the wake of IBA's own affidavit that is not a legal entity. Commemorating the Golden Jubilee celebrations of the Bank Nationalization Day on 19 July 2009, ANBF observed the day as a promise to our patrons, POP, way of reciprocating our commitment to the customers and assuring them our best service. The program were conducted in all states by our affiliates assuring the customers of good service. ANBF took up with Indian Banks Association to urge the Reserve Bank of India and the Government of India to postpone the implementation of IndAS and form an eminent group of members to study the IndAS provisions in the Indian context and suggest suitable changes. The implementation of IndAS has been postponed by RBI without mentioning any time limit. A training center under the auspices of ANBF named Chennai Academy for Banking Studies, Training and Research is functioning at the ANBF of Chennai for the purpose of imparting knowledge in various facts of banking. Under the aegis of CAPSTAR, two-day defense workshop was held at various centers across the country. The first of such workshop was conducted in Trivandrum on 24th and 25th February 2018. Bangalore workshop was held on 24th and 25th March 2018. Chandigarh workshop was conducted on 12th May and 13th May of 2018. ANBF State Unit for the State of Punjab and Chandigarh was formed on 12th May 2018. Comrade Harmeet Singh from FBOE was elected as the State Secretary and Comrade Gurmeet Singh from CBA was elected as the President of State Unit. And friends, regarding the accounts, audited accounts for the year 17-18, it is circulated? Yes, sir. It is circulated. The position of the subscription arrears is annexed with the report and I request our affiliates who have still not paid to clear the dues, but they have already paid. My acknowledgements, I extend my sincere thanks to all those colleagues who are sharing their expertise, experience and support even after the retirement. I acknowledge the role of our top-level office bearers who extended their helping hand for counseling the youngsters in overcoming the pressure of expectations and their performance. I thank all the office bearers for their immense contribution for the progress of the federation. I thank the treasurer for maintaining the account in such a manner that my intervention is kept at minimum level. I am thankful to Mrs. Thiyarajan and co-auditors of the association for their support in timely completion of the auditing of the balance accounts and for their guidance and support in various matters. I acknowledge the assistance of Central Government members for ensuring smooth running of the Federation. Before concluding, my sincere and heartfelt gratitude to the members throughout the country for their unstinted support, love and affection towards me and my team, for which I will be extremely obliged to them. I express my sincerest thanks to them at this moment. I wish all the best for the new team that will take over this, after this conference, to bring glory to the Federation and assist in its progression. With this, friends, my report is concluded. I am tabling it for your discussion and adoption.
Over. We can. Yeah. And then thereafter, we can invite for the discussion.
Okay.
Because I am having this stopwatch, this bell, everything ready.
We have circulated 19 official resolutions which was approved duly by our central committee. I would like to propose this resolution. After reading, perhaps I request my president to second it for your consideration. Resolution number 1, health of banking industry mergers and moves for privatization. Kindly go through that. These resolutions were drafted with a lot of labor, which madam was appreciating it. It will be giving a very good input to you while addressing your members. Post 91 reforms, banking industry has been undergoing a sea change. Financial sector companies in banking and insurance have always been a coveted carrot for the FIIs as well as the MNCs who want to reap maximum returns for the investments without caring little about the common people of the land. Government after government, headed by different political parties, are keen in helping them irrespective of the difference in their views in respect of other issues. They are not different from each other when the question of allowing FDI or disinvestment in the public sector. They try to outsmart their previous governments by remaining loyal to the
external... Kindly switch over to next resolution.
Anji?
Switch over to next resolution.
Acha. So, This fifth triennial conference of All India Nationalist Bank Federation urges the Union Government of India to preserve the public sector banks by amalgamating promising private sector banks into public sector banks, to make available the best HR practices among the amalgamated banks to all the employees in the respective amalgamated entities, and also not to go ahead with the formation of golden companies, not to reduce the stake of government in PSBs, and not to privatize any public sector banks further. And resolution number 2, in this the fifth triennial conference, it demands that the formation of payment banks and small finance banks should summarily be stopped forthwith, and the existing small finance banks should be regulated so that they should charge interest not exceeding that of the public sector banks for various credit products. I'll just give you a small hint. These payment banks and particularly the small banks, they are their target group is all small people in the villages, and there is no restriction on them to charge interest for their advances. And I learned that Shriram Housing Finance Company charged 21.25% for the housing loan in a village. So we, the public sector banks, wants that they should be stopped further, or their interest charging activities also should be regulated. And resolution 3, non-performing assets, willful defaulters and IBC. And this conference demands from the Union Government of India that officers who undertake recovery process give adequate protection to them. The security charged to the banks are disposed of easily, notwithstanding the bottlenecks brought in by the customers. The provisions of Revenue Recovery Act are made available across the country, and more powers are provided to the banks. The defaulters do not get any additional credit from the banking system. Their passports are blocked. They are not allowed to conduct elections or to hold any public office. They do not get any benefit or privilege from the government. Anybody who are identified as a willful defaulters. This kind of stringent action should be initiated by us. This is my third resolution. My fourth resolution is on the provisioning for standard assets. And this federation conference urges the Reserve Bank of India to modify the existing provisioning norms in such a way that a rationalized system of provisioning for standard assets is adopted, and banks are permitted to write back the provisions made for standard assets during the loss making years. It is all to adjust the balance sheet so as to show our real real income, or rather profit. Resolutions number 5 on income tax to be calculated on the balance sheet. The fifth triennial conference urges the Union Government of India to amend the Income Tax Act suitably so that the income tax payable by the banks is to be calculated only on the net profit of the banks after making provision as per the IRAC norms and other guidelines of the regulator and government. Presently, my dear friends, the income tax is charged on the gross income. After that, we are making provisions also. If the provisions are made, to that extent the profit will come down, then they can make any income tax, if at all any profit is left with. But these people, first they are taking the income tax, then they are giving the space for making provisions. This we want to roll it back. Appointment of officers and employee directors. This conference demands that the Union Government should desist from remaining inactive and to continue the existing procedure of appointing representative officers on the boards of their banks by adhering to the choice exercised by the major trade union of the respective banks. Resolution 7 on ensuring work-life balance. The conference demands that strict implementation of fixed working hours for officers whereby they are not made to work more than 8 hours per day is required. In the event of late sitting or working on Sundays, holidays, compensation equal to twice the quantum of salary per hour should be paid to them for every fraction of hour spared by the officers. They too on emergency basis. We are not available for working beyond 5 or 5:30. I should say 5, beyond working hours. Then why the IBAs say that working hours is 10 to 5? So we should not sit in the branch beyond 5 o'clock. And we are responsible officers in case of emergency in the branch. Anytime we can be called. But for that, there should be suitable monetary compensation, twice the salary. It should be given to us. And resolution number 8, 5-day banking. This fifth triennial conference demands that there should be 5-day week for the banks, enabling them to have meaningful work-life balance and attend their work with a renewed energy and enthusiasm, resulting in increased productivity. And resolution number 9, this is proposed because our offices are liable to be transferred anywhere in India. And it is happening, the offices, even these all India offices, so-called IAS offices, at the time of getting into the job, they are allotted to a state. Till their retirement, they will be in the state only. The only bank officers, they don't know which age, what part of the country they will be transferred. So, though we accepted it as our culture, we want some of the facilities to be given to us to mitigate our problems. So, this fifth triennial conference urges the Union Government of India to treat the children of bank officers on par with the children of transferable central government employees, to automatically admit them in Kendriya Vidyalayas, Navodaya Vidyalayas and other central schools, and also to explore the formation of separate schools for the children of bank officers, employees on the line of Kendriya Vidyalayas, if not by the government, by the IBA. Resolution number 10, this because of young women officers in the system, 38%, I told that, some states it has crossed even 50%. And keeping these young mothers, this resolution is proposed. This conference demands from IBA that common CRES facilities for the officers of the bank are to be provided at all centers where there are two bank branches or more for the officers of all banks in that particular center and nearby places. Why I have brought specifically that? Some of the banks, they have opened the CRES and they are taking a stand that sufficient patronage is not there. So instead of one bank owns it and claiming like this, for the banking system, they can have a crush. It can be managed by the IBA also. If the it can be given to Canara Bank to manage, and there, children, kids of other bank officers also can be brought and admitted. It will be a viable one. And construction of hospitals in ESI model. The fifth triennial conference, friends, it is also very much necessary because when we are interviewing the senior persons, elderly persons after retirement, they are telling almost 60% of their pension goes towards the medication or treatment. So this we are demanding. So this conference demands that the offices of the public sector bank should be provided with medical facilities on the same model of the ESI scheme, at least in all the district quarters of the country. Let IBA construct the hospitals, the ESI model, sufficient money they are having, or otherwise we are prepared to contribute to. Resolution number 12, this conference urges the IBA to implement the scheme in letter and spirit whereby the hospitalization expenses of the officers are paid in full to them by the banks, which can later take reimbursement from insurance companies as their internal arrangements. Kindly understand, our officers are finding difficult to claim the reimbursement because these insurance companies are really coming in the way. The original crux of the very scheme is, the bank is supposed to give the entire money, up to 4 lakhs, they got insurance. Their liability got insured with the insurance companies. Nothing to do with officers. So, this ANBF urges the IBA to implement the scheme. Any expenditures, it should be immediately reimbursed by the bank and let them collect it from the insurance companies by claiming whatever form they want. It is what we are urging. Resolution number 13, it is very important for the nationalized banks, my dear friends. The uniform perquisites and common salary structure to all the officers. Very, very important resolution. Kindly listen. So this conference demands that there should be uniformity in the salary and the perquisites being paid to the officers of all the banks, and such salary and perquisites should be back to the maximum prevailing amount among all the banks subject to periodic revision. Here, inside we have mentioned that the nationalized bank officers also, who are competent, who are now selected through a stringent selection process, must be given a salary on par with the State Bank of India. Any kind of additional increment should be made available to all the nationalized bank officers also. Then running scale in salary for the officers, which we have been discussing in the morning also. We have got huge number of youth coming to the bank, and the number of banks are going to be reduced. When the number of banks are going to be reduced, in the name of rationalization, after amalgamation, number of branches also going to be reduced. And with the invention of lot of technical gadgets like artificial intelligence and all, perhaps the hub system will be implemented. So the promotional opportunities for the officers will be reduced. When the promotional opportunities are reduced, it is unfair on the part of the IBA or the bank linking your increment with your promotions and elevations when the promotional opportunities are not there. So the young officers who are numbering about 80%, within 15-20 years, if they are not getting promotion, they all will get stagnation, same amount of salary should be there. So we demand that officers in the public sector bank should be accorded running scale of pay on time scale basis to the next higher grade of pay without waiting for the promotion process to be declared by the bank. So even an officer, because of the system prevalent, may be retiring as an officer, but his salary should run up to CGM level, his basic pay, because you have not provided me the promotions. The taxation of gratuity and leave encashment. The conference demands from the Union Government of India to amend the Finance Act to exempt the bank officers from the taxation of the whole amount of gratuity and the entire encashment received by the officers at the time of retirement. This is there only for the bank officers. The government officers, Income Tax Department has given exemption. We want, being a nationalized bank officers, these exemptions should be made available to bank officers also. Number 16, staff welfare measures by the banks. This conference demands that the expenses for the staff welfare scheme of the banks should be calculated only on the operating profit earned by the banks and not on their net profits. Under Resolution 17, medical insurance for retired officers, the fifth triennial conference demands that the respective banks should bear the cost of the health insurance scheme provided for the retired officers in full, either by making upfront payment or by reimbursing such cost to those retired officers who opt for the scheme. We'll have to take care of them also. Then Resolution number 18, updation of pension. This conference demands that the Union Government should come out with automatic updation of pension scheme with 100% utilization and sustainable family pension on par with the regulations available to the retired employees of the central government. Then scrapping of the new pension scheme. The fifth conference demands that the new pension scheme should be totally scrapped and all officers should be covered with a uniform fixed pension with automatic updation managed by the respective banks. So these are all the 9 resolutions, official resolution by ANB of Secretariat, proposed for your...
All the proposals are seconded by me and the entire presidium. And now, friends, you must have gone through it. I will request you to start, adopt all these resolutions, because that is as per our wish and demand. So that will be my request. If you want to do the value addition, then I will invite and I will give 5 minutes time. A stopwatch is here, call bell is here. Each delegate will get 2 minutes. So 5 minutes time is given to submit your name, name of the affiliate which you are representing. That you do. If there will be repetition, I will not allow. If there will be anything beyond the General Secretary report and the resolution, I will not allow. Then I will suggest that we will discuss in the evening. So with this, now the time starts. Stopwatch starts now. Three minutes gone. My dear friends, now, next agenda.
My president has directed me to give a reply to the members' observations. Huh? I read recently one thing. If a leader could not understand the silence of the members, he cannot understand their shoutings also. So we understood your silence, that all the resolutions, which was very important, which were presented to you with an idea to bring a comfortable work-life balance. When I am talking about the FIDA banking, you are overwhelmingly responding. It clearly indicates that you are longing for it. Why you are longing? You are suffering and suffocating because of this 24/7, 365 days. And when I am telling that this medical insurance or uniform perquisites, uniform salary, you were simply acknowledged. Why? Because you know that these are all your need. And rather, your acknowledgement, I am taking it as an appreciation that the leadership understood your demand. So that way, I have taken your silence as acknowledgement for the understanding of the our organization here. Friends, only one thing I want to stress here. I want something. Should I wait for somebody to come and give, or should I take it? Itna ye question. What we want. And I am 100% convinced I want. And at times I am pushed to the situation that without that I will not live. I cannot live. That is the scenario. In that kind of situation, what an individual should do? Should he wait for Sunil boy to come and give it to you? Or you will gain and gather courage to go and snatch it? Yeah, because in fact, my dear friends, when I joined in the bank in 1986, that was the time director good officers were joining in a small number. Sunil boy, myself, all we were. We got into the industry as a director good officers, but our number was only 10%. Almost 80 to 90% of the officers, they were promoted from the cadres of the clerks. So we were unable to rather gain a kind of courage to even discuss about the issues. We are always looking at the seniors, elders. They used to discourage us because 10 years he was a clerk doing only the job which was given to him. Officer, now he's a colleague. He will be discouraging youngsters like us. Hey, keep quiet, yaar. Oh, dada beta andar. Don't do this. I honestly expected after 2010, when the director of the officers took place in a big way, these officers will be definitely rising up to the occasion. And if there is a genuine demand, they will not hesitate to raise voice. I am reserving my comment within me. I am leaving it to you or you. Very good. He is telling. So friends, with all the youth in the system today, homogeneous group. Till 2010, the officers organization was not having a homogeneous group of officers. Age mein, educational level mein, experience mein, service mein, lot of difference was there. It is very difficult to bring a uniformity in thoughts. But today after 2010, all of you were recruited through IBPS who are in the nationalized banks. Big number of recruitment took place, same age, same educational qualification, same kind of treatment expectation, but whether same amount of militancy is there among the officers. It is a very big question to be thought. And these kind of meetings, it should serve the purpose of sending this strong signal to all of you. If something I demand, primarily I should ask for it. How to ask? Again, there is also a different issue. I can go and stylishly represent to them, this is I want. And if it is not given properly, continuously deprived, you can change your style also. But primarily you need whatever you want, which is genuine demand, it should be. And if you are keeping quiet, my dear friends, the other side also will be treating you like that only. In Tamil, there is a proverb, only crying child will get the milk. Only crying child. How? Even mother does not know whether the child needs the milk or not. It should cry. And in the Bible, a word is there. You knock the door, I will open the door. You demand, I will give. No IBA, no bank management is holier than the Jesus. Because even Jesus told you, demand, I will give. They are not holier than them. Are we demanding? Are we raising their voice? Majority of the place, it is not happening. Even after our leaders giving all kinds of comfort to you, all kinds of motivation to you, still it is not happening. I am openly admitting, my dear friends, sometime among the leaders we used to discuss, this is a genuine demand, genuine expectation, for which the trade union has to adopt a fighting mode. We must go on agitation. Who? Persons like our Sunil Bhai, who is going to retire this year, 60 years. He will fire, he will fight. His blood will be in fire. He will tell that, strike me, Johnny Gayer. Then immediately another genocide will ask, sir, member Jaya kya, sir? Immediately he will put water on his enthusiasm. Why that doubt should happen to a leader? Okay, I admit that your organization is formed to express the expectation of the members. I cannot expect that all the members should come forward to take up the fight. No, it should come from the leader. But when the leaders are having a comfort, when we are coming to the streets, they will be backed by the members. It is a big doubt in front of you. You are all office bearers in making, leaders in making, so I am telling you. Go and educate the members, my dear friends. Go and tell them. If I want, I should do that. Recently we announced in Canara Bank also, 5:30 leave the office. 5:30 leave the office. Come out of the branch, 5:30. Raise a slogan as CBOA Jindabad, Canara Bank Jindabad, kar jao. Sundays and holidays, be with the family. That's all. We have not told anything big. Additionally, you cannot be with your own family. But be with your family. It was the demand. One boy has telephoned me for the suggestion. How long, sir? He thought he said agitation. It's come to an end. Or I told you agitation. No, yaar, I only told you to be with your wife. How can you ask how long? Mind is conditioned. I told Marne Tak, all Sundays you must be with your wife till your death or her death. Why? Why this slavery mindset? Who prevented you from leaving the office by 5:30 when all our youth, all our youngsters, 2010 batch ka sir, still they are unable to get out. So my dear friends, forming the trade union is not a big deal. It needs only 7% on a small paper and 2% to sign. That's all. Some object is copy karo Google se. Ho gaya. But if you want to sustain the very objectives of the trade union, we need militant members. Very militant members. Leaders should be encouraged. Go, sir, I am following you. Leaders should not be driven to a situation that, please, come here. Where is the question, my dear friends? So on the eve of, we are laying down office. He is going to retire now. Manjari Gerji already retired. I am going to demote my office in May. Our Arvindarji, 2-3 saal ho gaya. Still, we are having this much involvement, enthusiasm. For what? Our children like you to be militant. For what? To take care of you and your family. That's all. But still you need a kind of encouragement. Where from it will come, my dear friends? If you want this All India Nationalist Bank Officers Federation to sustain, which has got the very solemn objectives of taking care of the well-being of the officers of the public sector bank. Every public sector bank officer should turn to be militant. He must demand. If it is not given, he must snatch. In old times, I told somewhere also, in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan told, you do your duty, don't expect anything. I don't understand, but still he is telling something in Sanskrit. Anyway, meaning is this, you do your duty or don't expect the benefits. Ye Bhagavan ka, Lord Krishna ka. That time when Lord Krishna was telling, Lord Krishna like general managers were there, MDs were there. When you are doing their duty, they are given without your asking. It was. But today, the ANBF is telling, do your duty, snatch your rights. No Lord Krishna, Krishna Sandhya. Do your duties because it is my bank. It is my country. It is my bank. Our bank. So we must do our duty to ensure that public sector banks must remain, not only to take care of me, my 70% of the people still relying on agriculture in rural sector. Madam told, no, I am fortunate that I studied, I got a job as a direct officer, I am working in the bank, I am in a position to give somebody some assistance. Fine, thanking God. So I will do my duty of taking care of this nation's economy. It is my nation, my people, my country. But I will not be waiting for somebody to give my rights. That is Bhagavad Gita gone. Now you must ready to snatch your rights, take your rights. A homogeneous group of officers today in the industry must ensure that mutually take care of everybody's interest. People ask us, regulated working hours chahiye sir. Regulated working hours. What is the meaning of regulated working hours? Already IBA has told 10 to 5 is the working hours. Question is, who must regulate? Regulated working hours, okay, that is your demand. My question is, who must regulate? Very branch manager ne regulate karne ka na? If the branch manager is not properly regulating, branch officers regulate karne ka hai. Itna gussa nahi hona chahiye bhai. नहीं बस थोड़ा ना ब्लड बॉइल हो रहा है नहीं तो माय डियर कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड रेगुलेटेड वर्किंग आवर्स हमारा हाथ में है यू डिसाइड व्हेन टू स्टार्ट व्हेन टू गो होम हमारा टाइम है था ऑल सीनियर पर्संस एज्ड पर्सन they were having fear of seeing their wife in the evening, not going home. But you all youth, enjoy life, yaar. Get out, go out, enjoy life. I am telling you, when you see, day for yesterday, we conducted a brainstorming session all over the country. CBOA conducted a brainstorming session. What is the merits and demerits of going home by 5:30? Pura, I will circulate it. I am consolidating. Uday is doing the job. I consolidate. Everybody has appreciated. Sir, by leaving the branch by 5:30, I am able to see my wife in sunlight. She looks beautiful. Very big change. I am able to see my parents. I am able to see my children playing. I have registered myself for some online courses. The guitar, what I have forgotten during my college days, I started doing, sir. And when I am going out, I am able to meet my other customers. And leisure time, baithe ke main SMS deta hun customer ko, recovery ko. It is excellent, sir. It gives me confidence. It gives me a confidence. I can manage any situation. So I have to go by 5:30. Go. If you want to go by 5:30, go. And our management is recently blinking. They are really blinking now. Officers are leaving by 5:30. Nobody can touch. last 25 days, Canara Bank Officer Association mein, all the officers, 93.5% of the officers all over the country in Canara Bank, leaving the office by 5:30 for the last 25 days, no loss took place. This quarter also, we made profit. So, my dear friends, choice is yours. How to conduct yourself in the family, in the branch, in the organization, it is your choice. If you want to remain as a slave, choice is yours. You do that. If you want to behave like a male to snatch all the benefits so that your personal life will be good, again, choice is yours. Kindly take care of this man. Next agenda is office bearers boss. Proposed team.
Leader sitting on the dais, I am not going to take much of your time. And it does not mean that I want to give you any comfort. I don't have much time. That's why I am not going to give you much time. Whatever way I could have discharged my duty, I am very contented a person. And I am not carrying anything. The baggage is offloaded. Sweet memories will be there. I am a born fighter and will continue to fight. I have fought many battles during the last 3 years, more than 3 years. And Comrade Mani Maran is aware of that, few of my friends from Chennai, that on health front, then on the family front too, because it was my pious duty to keep my family members' morale very high, my extended family, my friends in Bank of India, to whom I owe a lot for all their support given to me when it was needed by me the most, and then my friends in AINBF too, AIBOC too. The way settlement, perhaps Comrade Somo will come out tomorrow with certain detail. I can tell you that 5 days a week, updation of pension, family pension, everything is there. On the cards, some progress is there. And we hope to have it. Friends, now it is a high time that we should come out of the UFU. We have formed the officers' organization, where all the four officers' organizations are there. And when Raj Kiran Rayaji was very furious, my friends from Union Bank, who are not here, they know him very well. When we were asking for something, then he said, you have a convener, you will have to speak to Bandlis. I cannot talk to everyone. I told him, you cannot force us to root the demand of the officers through a clerk. What of that? He is convener of the UOBU. Moreover, sir, if you don't want everybody to speak, then you come alone, I will come alone, we will settle the wage settlement. I am senior to two in the banking industry. And many more things I told him in front of everybody, which I would not like to repeat here, because tomorrow he is, day after he is coming as a guest. Lot of threatening, lot of fighting. In a State Bank corporate office, I had said, Rajneesh Kumar ji, dar lagta nahi to aap dara kisko rahe ho? Strike hoga. For the first time, as a negotiator from the officer side, we sat in the negotiation table along with a placard on our chest that we had done. It's not that I am going to tell you about my bravery. I'm just telling you that the job which was assigned to me, that I did to the fullest of my capacity, and whatever way the organization feels, we'll go for the organization. After superannuation, I do not become a waste that I should be dumped in a basket. I cannot. Nobody can do it. If you will have the that spirit, I'll be fighting at some other platform, at some other places. You cannot dump. When I had chosen the path of trade union, that was my choice. When I will stop it, that will be my choice. If you have written something somewhere, that doesn't apply to me. Nobody can dump me. Because tomorrow, if I stop doing trade union, then what will happen? Where will I stand? What justification I will give to my family? What I will tell? And I know, if you do not exert, then what will happen? In 1917, there was a football match between Chelsea and Arsenal by the side of the Liverpool Bridge. There was one stadium. All at a sudden, the weather became very foggy. Nothing was visible. The goalkeeper of Chelsea was a very renowned goalkeeper. He was standing, stretched his hands, very attentive. The moment the ball will come, I will stop. I will not let the ball go to the goalpost. When he saw that ball is not coming, then he was very happy. My forwards are doing their duty. They are keeping the ball in the half of the opposition. He was not aware that the match was abandoned. He could not listen to the whistle of the referee due to the noises which were coming from the stand. And later on he came to know that all those his friends for whom he was standing, guarding the goalpost with all sincerity, they have left him and they have gone. Then he wrote one sentence. Was it not for all those for whom I was standing in the goalpost to come to me and ask me, the match has been abandoned, now let us go. I was standing all alone. I'm not that sort of a person that I will be facing this situation. When I'm working for you, you will have to acknowledge that, yes, I'm working for you. You will have to prove that. Whatever I have done wrong. And moreover, I haven't worked for the appreciation. A person who joined the bank in year 1984 as a DRO, completed 16 years on 15th of the January and completed 37 years of the service as an officer on 16th of the January. If he had come to the trade union, there must be some commitment, not any compulsion. There was no compulsion as such. I am really indebted to all my leaders from my federation who could prevail upon me here in Kolkata itself in year 2019. You should continue. And I have never come off lost, because if I have got the real concern, the concern which Comrade Manivaran was showing. Only I am not a whistleblower. Simply, I will not tell you that you wake up and then I will go. Maybe that you could not have heard me out of your deep slumber. So it is my duty to wake you up, to put you on the right path, to continue the battle, to carry on the baton. AINVF, I was party to it when it had taken birth. I have seen the travels also. I have seen the opportunistic politics also. I have seen clash of ego also. I had been witness to that. Even then, the AINVF is moving. People tried to finish it off. They could not do it. Now the golden days with the new leadership is again coming back. If the banking industry remains, if the public sector banks remains, AINVF is bound to flourish. I wish that all of you should have one umbrella under AINVF, which will provide you all the security needs which will take care of your legitimate demands. That will create a situation where you can live your life with self-respect and dignity. The self-respect and dignity is more important for me, for you. Don't think, if you do not go home on time, maybe that your family members will learn to live without you. Don't take a chance. Once they will learn to live without you, then where will you go? So, very rightly, comrade, Mani Maran has said, our General Secretary has said, that it is you who has to live the life. जैसे कहते हैं ना कि जब मरना मुझे है तो मैं मरूंगा कैसे, ये डिसीजन मेरा होगा. ये डिसीजन आप कैसे ले सकते हो कि मैं कैसे मरूंगा. वैसे ही जब जीना मुझे है तो ये डिसीजन आप कैसे ले सकते हो कि मुझे कैसे जीना है, मैं कैसे जीऊंगा, वह भी डिसीजन मेरा होगा. विद फ्यू वर्ड्स आई कंक्लूड माई स्पीच विच हैज कम टू यू बाई वे ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड. All the very best. Get going. Keep your morals high. And once again, I will reiterate. The trade unions were born during the distress. They have survived during the distress. Whenever the comfortable situation came, the trade union started losing its teeth. So on your professional front and your family front, I wish all the very best. And now, I will request all the persons who are sitting on the dais to kindly vacate the dais. Now the next agenda will be election of the office bearers and committee members, for which I, in consultation with the General Secretary, propose. So I propose name of Comrade Mani Maran to be as the election commissioner to conduct the election. But before that, it was very, Sanjay Manjrekar. Before that, I knew that you will laugh. That always happens, my dear friend. People are waiting always. The moment you will falter, they will start laughing. Very good. I provided you an opportunity to laugh. You will get many more. Sanjay Manjrekar ji, very good friend of mine, very matured a leader, for whom I have a lot of respect. He superannuated. He was carrying on the battle of Syndicate Bank Officer Association as per their constitutional provisions. But Modi ji thought that there should be only one leader of his style, and that Modi ji is there, so he decided that Syndicate Bank should be merged with CBOA. And Comrade Manjrekar is contributing as an advisor to CBOA for his roles played in AINVF. Always he was to our side. I am missing Comrade Prakash Karotia also, if he would have been here. There were only few persons who used to raise the voice, who used to show the guts. He was one of them. I wish him all the very best, and I request him with the folded hand that whatever he has, he should keep using that. He should keep guiding the youngsters. He should contribute towards making the trade unions richer. And there was a novel from Thomas Hardy that die empty. If at all you have to die, don't carry anything. Your knowledge, your passion, everything you should pass on to others. So die empty. I wish he will continue to enlighten the younger generation, to the senior leaders also, in his own way. It is up to you to utilize his services. Because I know he is not having any hidden agenda like me. He is pure trade unionist. He always believes in some ethical value. Sometimes he will be telling me so many things, ethical things. And I appreciate that, but sometimes we need to be very practical than to be ethical. अगर मुझे रोड में बाएं तरफ से जाना और कोई गलत आ रहा है तो मैं बाएं तरफ छोड़ के अपने आप को बचाऊंगा ना, कि ट्रैफिक रूल पालन करके ट्रक के नीचे चला जाऊंगा. So that diversion, that flexibility one should have. So thank you Manjrekar Sahib for being with us, for all your contributions, and looking forward for your contributions ahead. Now one more responsibility we have given you, that you conduct the election for the new office bearers and committee members. Last but not least, thank you very much, my dear comrades, my dear friends. You all are my family members. I owe a lot to all of you. Thank you very much. इतना नारा लगा इसीलिए हम लौट आए, आधा घंटा भी और बोलेंगे. इसके बाद हमको पता नहीं मिलेगा कि नहीं मिलेगा बोलने के लिए. दोस्तों, देयर इज वेरी वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट दैट टुमारो दैट थ्रोट स्वैब टेस्ट विल बी कंडक्टेड एट हयात रिजेंसी फ्रॉम 8:30 AM. आप लोग सभी लोगों से ये रिक्वेस्ट है कि जिनको कोरोना नहीं है वो टेस्ट जरूर करा लें, क्योंकि जिनको है वो तो यहां होंगे नहीं. तो जिनको कोरोना नहीं है वो टेस्ट करा लें, बिकॉज विदाउट दैट परहैप्स यू विल नॉट बी परमिटेड टू इंटर इनटू द डेलीगेट सेशन हॉल डे आफ्टर टुमारो. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स.
आई कॉल द हाउस टू ऑर्डर. आई हैव बीन गिवन द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू कंडक्ट द इलेक्शंस फॉर द सेंट्रल कमिटी for the next term of 3 years, and elections will be held in terms of bylaw number 5 of the constitution or bylaws of All India Nationalized Banks Officers Federation. As per bylaw number 5B of the constitution, there are 43 posts in the Central Committee, but in expecting that some more affiliates may join, the Executive Committee had decided to keep some positions vacant, and now we are going to fill in 29 vacancies through the elections in this house. The number of vacancies, I will read the post and the vacancies against the each post. We will have chairman 1, president 1, working president 1, vice presidents 8, general secretary 1, joint general secretary 6, deputy general secretary 8, treasurer 1, assistant treasurer 1, and secretary 1, total number of posts 29. As per regulation 6A, the election to the various post office bearers that be held at the meetings of the All India General Body. The All India General Body shall appoint as returning, or that is done. Only delegates of the respective General Body shall be eligible to contest the elections. Candidature of every contestant shall be proposed and seconded by 2 separate delegates, and elections shall be held by secret ballot. So these are the rules. Now I call for the nominations for the post already declared by me, that is Chairman 1 post, President 1, Working President 1, Vice Presidents 8, General Secretary 1, Joint General Secretary 6, Deputy General Secretary 8, Treasurer 1, Assistant Treasurer 1, and Secretary 1. I call for the nominations now. We will keep the nominations open for 15 minutes. Now it is 4:55. We will keep nomination open up to 5:10.
Sir, comrade, I want to propose the name of our panel contesting this election procedure. I am Tarun Kumar Shah from Bank of India Officers Association. I propose the name of the for the post of chairman, Comrade Sunil Kumar, President B.K. Mehta, Working President Vilas Nayak, Vice President Uday Ladia, Vice President Comrade Nagesh G., Vice President Comrade Jacob, Vice President Comrade Rajiv Nigam, Vice President Comrade Pavu Day, Vice President Comrade Sriram Raj, Vice President Comrade Pankaj Kapoor, Vice President Comrade Shetang Trivedi, General Secretary Comrade G.V. Monimaran, Joint General Secretary Comrade Sanjay Das, Joint General Secretary Comrade Kannan V., Joint General Secretary Comrade Richard B.K., Joint General Secretary Comrade Ninga Reddy, Joint General Secretary Comrade B.L. Madhur, General Secretary Comrade Mahendra Donse, Deputy General Secretaries, Deputy General Secretary Comrade Kislaya, Deputy General Secretaries Comrade Dhananjay Singh, Deputy General Secretary Comrade Amarnath N, Deputy General Secretary Comrade Kamaljit Mahapatra, Deputy General Secretary Comrade Krishnan V.V., Deputy General Secretary Comrade Nilesh Pawar, Deputy General Secretary Comrade K.V. Desai, Deputy General Secretary Comrade Benos Sebastian, Treasurer Comrade Richard Narayan Saha, Assistant Treasurer Dr. Abhijit Mandal, Secretary Comrade Tarun Shah. Thank you.
I am Prabhu of Canara Bank Officer Association. I second in the names proposed by Sir.
I, Hariharan Bhaskar, from Bank of India Officers Association, I second the proposal of panel put forward by Comrade Tarun Shah.
I request the proposers and seconders to come and sign the list proposed by them as proposer and seconder. I request the candidates to come and accept the candidature. I will call the names. Let them accept the candidature. I will call the names. They should communicate their acceptance for the nomination. Comrade Sunil Kumar for the post of chairman, accept. Comrade B.K. Mehta for the post of president, accepted. Comrade Vilas Nayak for the post of working president, accepted. Comrade Uday Lodaya for the post of senior vice president. Comrade Nagesh G for the post of senior vice president. Comrade Jacob for vice president post. Comrade Rajiv Nigam, vice president. Comrade Prabhu D, vice president. Comrade Sairam Raj, vice president. Comrade Pankaj Kapoor, vice president. Comrade Swetang Trivedi, vice president. Comrade G.V. Manimaran, General Secretary. Comrade Sanjay Das, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Kannan V, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Richariya B.K., Joint General Secretary. Comrade Linga Reddy, Joint General Secretary. Comrade B.L. Madhur, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Mahendra Dhonse, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Kislaya, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Dhananjay Singh, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Amarnath Yen, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Kawaljit Mahapatra, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Krishnan V.V., Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Nilesh Pawar, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Kirti Duggal, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Bennett Sebastian, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Ujwal Narayan Saha, Treasurer. Comrade Dr. Abhijit Mandal, Assistant Treasurer. Comrade Tarun Saha, Secretary. So these are the 29 nominations received for 29 posts. I will wait for another 5 minutes to close the nominations. Kya aayega na tab tak? Nahi aayega. Nahi, mujhe nahi chahiye, sabko. Nahi aayega. हो गया. सो कमरेड, इफ नो मोर नॉमिनेशंस आर देर एंड सिंस ऑल हैव एक्सेप्टेड द नॉमिनेशंस, आई टेक इट दैट नोबडी इज गोइंग टू विथड्रॉ देयर कैंडिडेचर. आई डिक्लेयर ऑल द 29 कैंडिडेट्स इलेक्टेड अनअपोस्ड. I will read the names and request all the candidates to come on the dais, all the elected representatives to come on the dais. Comrade Sunil Kumar, Chairman. Comrade B.K. Mehta, President. Comrade Vilas Nayak, Working President. Comrade Uday Lodaya, Senior Vice President. Comrade Nagesh G, Senior Vice President. Comrade Jacob, Vice President. Comrade Rajiv Nikam, Vice President. Comrade Prabhu D, Vice President. Comrade Sairam Raj, Vice President. Comrade Pankaj Kapoor, Vice President. Comrade Shwetang Trivedi, Vice President. Comrade G.V. Manimaran, General Secretary. Comrade Sanjay Das, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Kannan V, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Richaria, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Linga Reddy, Joint General Secretary. Comrade B.L. Madhur, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Mahendra Dhonse, Joint General Secretary. Comrade Kislaya, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Dhananjay Singh, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Amarnath N, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Kawaljit Mahapatra, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Krishnan V.V., Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Nilesh Pawar, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Kirti Duggal, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Bennett Sebastian, Deputy General Secretary. Comrade Ujwal Narayan Saha, Treasurer. Comrade Dr. Abhijit Mandal, Assistant Treasurer. And Comrade Tarun Saha, Secretary. I congratulate all the candidates and I wish them every success during their term of next 3 years. I also thank the Executive Committee and the office bearers for having given me this opportunity to be the election commission for this election. Thank you, comrades. I hand over the mic to Chairman Comrade Sunil Kumar.
And I will hand over the mic to Comrade Mani Maran, our General Secretary.
Thank you very much, my dear friends, who have reposed confidence in us to take care of the All India Nationalized Bank's Officer Federation for the next term. And on behalf of the entire committee, who is with me, I express my sincere thanks, gratitude. And we take a vow that we will be guarding the objectives of All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation. The days to come, we all will be striving hard to further strengthen this movement, and we will all will be working for getting all the benefits to the All India Nationalized Bank Officers Federation's officers. And I also thank our election commissioner, returning officer, for this smooth way of conducting this election. And I know there will be some grudge among our sister colleagues, and in our system, the sister colleagues will be nominated, co-opted. Certainly, without you, we cannot function. You will be finding place in our central committee very shortly. And friends, as per the rich tradition of this ANBF, we will be continuing our job, and here I want to make a commitment. On my laying down the office, when I want, I will be followed by our Sanjay Das, General Secretary of this office. And with all your unstinted support, I am really hopeful. I am very confident. The days to come, this umbrella federation will be emerging as a guiding factor of all the nationalized bank offices and all the nationalized banks too. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Comrades, ladies and gentlemen, today's events would conclude with the national anthem. I request one and all of you to be on the attention for the national anthem to follow.
মনোয়ধিনায়ক জয় হে ভারত ভাগ্য বিধাতা পাঞ্জাব সিন্ধু গুজরাট মারাঠা দ্রাবিড় উৎকল বঙ্গ বিন্দু হিমাচল যমুনা গঙ্গা উচ্ছল জলধি তরঙ্গ তব শুভ নামে জাগে তব শুভ আশিস মাগে গাহে তব জয় গাথা জনগণ মঙ্গলদায়ক জয় হে ভারত ভাগ্য বিধাতা জয় হে জয় হে জয় হে জয় 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 হে
ছবিটা ভালো করে তোর ফেসবুকে দিবি খারাপ হচ্ছে পড়ে যাবে